So far in this module, I have talked a lot about energy in chemical reactions. In addition to requiring energy, some biochemical processes require molecules to be reduced. Chemically speaking, reduction is the gain of electrons. Oxidation is the opposite of reduction and happens when a molecule loses electrons. A handy way to remember this is the mnemonic oil rig, which stands for oxidation is loss and reduction is gain. In organic chemistry, a carbon atom is said to become more oxidized as more electronegative atoms, such as oxygen, bond to it. This is because the electronegative atoms draw electrons away from the carbon atom, leaving it relatively electron poor. In any reduction-oxidation, or redox, reaction, at least one molecule is oxidized and at least one is reduced. There cannot be oxidation of one molecule without a corresponding reduction of another. Many metabolic reactions involve reduction and oxidation. The cell has specific molecules that are commonly used as electron carriers. These molecules accept electrons in some reactions and donate them in others. Two key molecules of this type are nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, NAD, and nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, NADP. These molecules are very similar to each other in terms of their basic structure. As their name suggests, each contains two nucleotides. As we saw before with ATP, a nucleotide contains a monosaccharide to which is joined a nitrogenous base and at least one phosphate group. In NAD and NADP, one nitrogenous base is adenine and the other is nicotinamide, and the two nucleotides are joined together through the phosphate groups. The only difference between NAD and NADP is that NAD has a hydroxyl group on carbon 2 of the sugar of the adenine nucleotide, while NADP has a phosphate group attached to this carbon. These molecules can carry electrons on the nicotinamide chemical group, so let's take a look at that group in detail. In its oxidized form, the nicotinamide ring carries a positive charge, and the two molecules are abbreviated NAD+, or NADP+. Addition to nicotinamide of a hydride ion, H-, which is equivalent to a proton and two electrons, neutralizes the charge. Note that reduction of the nicotinamide ring requires two electrons. In their reduced form, the molecules are abbreviated NADH or NADPH. Similar to the way cells use ATP as a source of energy for chemical reactions, they use NADH and NADPH as sources of electrons. Although NADH and NADPH are both reducing agents of equivalent strength and differ in structure by only a phosphate group, they have different roles in metabolism. Electrons from NADH are used primarily to regenerate ATP from ADP, while electrons from NADPH are used primarily in the synthesis of biomolecules. Another chemical group that can accept electrons is the quinone group. This group is found in the molecule ubiquinone, or coenzyme Q, which you will encounter again in the citric acid cycle and electron transport chain. Like the nicotinamide group, the quinone group acquires two electrons to go from its oxidized form to its reduced form. Along with the two electrons, it gains two protons, and so the reduced form of coenzyme Q is abbreviated QH2. Now that we have gone over these fundamental concepts related to metabolism, we are in a good position to look at the biochemical pathways of energy metabolism and how they are regulated.